back. In this video, Mr. Lim is going to be addressing the cost of healthcare. The cost of healthcare is of a main concern, and in most of our emails that we have received, the feedback that we are getting from you, healthcare seems to be at the top of the list. Of course, why not? Singapore has an aging population, and every Singaporean is concerned, how am I able to foot the bill that is rising all the time? I'm glad today Mr. Desmond Lim is here with us. For those of you who still have more feedback, ideas, strategies, tools to make our lives better, or just questions you want answered, please email singaporeelections@gmail.com. But today, Mr. Lim is going to address this issue of escalating healthcare prices. Mr. Lim, your views, especially how are you going to help with the proposals to bring this cost down or at least keep it affordable? Mr. Lim, please.
What if for a major surgery that costs $25,000, you only have to pay only $8 out of pocket cash? You may be asking, how is this possible? Yes, it is possible. Only if you have a private integrated sealed plan offered by insurance companies, the coverage is on as charge basis compared to our national MediShield plans. Above plans are MediSafe approved hospitalization scheme where premiums can be funded through our MediSafe account. But there is a cap of $800 per year for age below 80 and $1,150 for those above age 80. That one can use to pay for the medical plan annual premium. My question is then, why cap the MediSafe at $800 and $1,150? Why are we not allowing them to use their MediSafe accounts in accordance to their needs at the point of attaining medical assistance? We all worry for our aging populations. Yet, the government is setting parameters that add stress to this potentially large group in the making. How much cash saving does the government expect the elderly to set aside so that they are able to pay an account of this yearly recurrent cost? My proposal, remove the cap for the age 65 and above, allow them to fully utilize their MediSafe so that they are able to fund the premium. Also, the financial burden of this cost will not just affect our elderly. It will also give additional stress to the young families who are supporting them. Imagine the financial burdens of families having to juggle their day-to-day expenses, build savings and accounts for the cash supports for their aging parents. Vote me in to fight for this cause so your parents have more access to funds and you, their children, can reduce your financial commitments and build your saving nets.
Your proposal to remove the cap for those above 65 is a very refreshing proposal. I'm glad your ideas are new, and I'm glad your ideas will make the lives of all of us Singaporeans much better. Thank you for sharing them with us. And viewers at home, ladies and gentlemen, residents of Punggol East, if you have any questions, feedback, or if you have any ideas you want to share with us, because we are one people, one nation, one Singapore, let us work together to make our lives better. Let us work together to make our future better. And most importantly, vote this weekend for Mr. Desmond Lim. Let SDA be your voice in Parliament. Thank you.